join us now is one of the true legends of musical theater and a lady who's always lived life to the fullest. Her autobiography has just been released in a brand new second edition, and it's called My Heart Belongs. We all could fill in the last two words of that. Would you welcome Mary Martin?
How are you going to follow us?
Between two roses.
Look at the two Peter Pans sitting together.
He's the young one.
Ah, Mary, look at you. You look sensational.
Well, I'm moving.
Yeah, and you're feeling good, I trust.
Excellent. No
hangovers from that. Not hangovers, is a terrible word. She's not a drinker.
Hang up.
Bad feelings
what
from that.
What is the word?
Overlaps. No,
Residual effects.
Residual effects. Oh, that was...
This you don't get residuals from.
No. From the accident is what I was saying.
I know, no.
No problem.
No, I have some, but I ignore them.
Yeah.
Your darling boy said, now, be careful, there are two steps, and go stage right.
Yeah.
And, you know, all through Peter Pan, I would start he'd say, Miss Martin, stage left, I'd go right. And then we'd say, Miss Martin, stage right, I go left.
Oh, and isn't that terrible?
Well, but I knocked out several Wendy's like that. You know?
And upstage and downstage and all those special words.
I always knew where that was. It was just right and left.
Yeah. But downstage, you know, and upstage.
Yes, because that's next. That's going down to the public, okay, and coming back.
Bring me up to date on Janet Gaynor.
She's better, thank the good Lord, and that is the truth. She's walking now, and she can walk a mile a day. Mm. She tries it. She's up to that now. Mm. And she's swimming.
I'm glad to hear that.
And she's really coming along. She's had a very rough time.
Yes, I know.
Very, very rough. But she's going to make it.
Where could you write to her?
I could tell you.
Could you? Yeah. I should drop her note. I'd done something with her about a month before that.
Yes. So
yeah.
Did you too?
Yeah. Had just done an interview
he
with her?
He was my teacher, and you were my professor.
Oh, really?
First time I was ever on television.
That's right.
First time ever, to
a talk show. Yes.
Is that so?
Yes, and I just sat there, you know, thought I was going to die. So
then you ended up doing your own talk show.
Yes.
Sure. Did you used to work under the name Moms Mabley?
No.
I know I've seen you somewhere.
No, I'm the original. Mary Martin.
Off stage here.
When I performed in Texas once, it was the second time I did Annie Get Your Gun, and this little ballet dancer said, I'm going to call my friend in Texas and tell her about me being in your show, and she did. Mm. And she said, I'm in a show, and she says, what you doing? I'm doing Hello Dolly. And she said, who's in it? And she said, Mary Martin. And there was no sound from the other side. And she said, did you hear what I say? And she said, yes. You mean the original Mary Martin?
Not a reproduction.
You're now looking at the original. I've been off the lot.
On all of those great shows that you made famous, Mary, and luckily I got to see a few of them, and just those are magical moments we in the audience will never, ever forget.
Mm.
Is there a night that sticks out more prominently than others?
I would say that as far as a night is concerned, I never remember opening nights because I'm absolutely paralyzed from, until I get out on the stage.
Are you
a
really?
A lot of people are. I get very sad on opening nights until I get on. And I just get sadder and sadder and sadder, and then I get on, and that's fine. Mm. But the matinees of Peter Pan... Oh, every matinee for 2 years, they'd talk back to Peter, and it was so thrilling. Oscar Hammerstein used to come on the matinees in New York and stand at the back just to hear the children.
Mm.
He loved the sound, so did I. The mothers would write me a lot of times, well, you've turned them on, and they crow, but how do I turn them off?
Your longest running show would have been South Pacific?
I was, yes, 3.5 years of South Pacific, because 2.5 in New York and 1 in London, and then 2.5 years in the South Pacific, 2.5 years almost of I Do, I Do. They were long runs.
Is there ever a day that you miss?
Being on?
Yeah.
No, now, I mean, I hate to say this because I've had such a fabulous career and really, you know, thank you.
It's so hard to believe.
But I can go and see a show and be a member of the audience and get so excited as if I'd never been in show business. You know, I just saw the real thing the other night. And I don't know what that is, except it must be that from when I was 19 and had three schools of dancing and put shows together, I feel of a show sitting there, you know, watching them, that's the excitement, is seeing what they're doing and it's something that's been put together so well.
But I can't believe, Mary, then forget a book show. What about a performance?
Oh, I have been performing since I was five.
Right.
And I love every minute of it.
Any desire to go into a club or...
Oh, aren't you tricky?
Why?
Well, did you look at the last part of the book?
These are the new chapters that are in for the second edition.
Don't bother about it. You'll read it. You don't have to do the whole book because you read
it. Is it a part about how you'd like to go into a little nightclub with the piano?
Yes.
Then, I got her. But, Mary, you mean a little kind of chic?
Well, I started here in this city at the Hotel Roosevelt when I was 19,
right,
I think.
Right down the street.
I think they're just now tearing it down and remaking it.
Are they tearing down the room?
I'm afraid to look.
Anyway, I started that, and that was my first job. So now I really don't have to do anything but what I would like to do. So I end the book saying, I started out in a bar and think I'd like to end up in one.
That's a good matter.
Well, Dick and I aren't doing anything after the show.
That's right. Neither of us has a friend in
town. I figured we'd all go together.
We'll come right back with Mary Martin and Dick Cavett after this message. We have a clip from...
Look at him trying to be unimpressed.
From the song that brought Mary to fame. But it first brought you to fame on Broadway.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And then in a motion picture called Night and Day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I was supposed to be playing myself. And I was discovered in a chorus, you know.
Which is true.
No, I was never on the stage when I played My Heart Belongs to Daddy. I'd never been on, except in Weatherford, Texas.
Now, the publicity always, Mary, was that you stepped out of the chorus and...
Was not one word of truth.
They threw you onto a stage with no New York
they
experience?
They had to, because the June Knight, you remember June Knight, the actress, had just married and left with her husband.
I happened
to walk in, and there we were. I didn't even know what I was auditioning for. By that time, I'd auditioned so many times, like... 10 times a day in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
And finally, never got the job. It's always the wrong song. Mm-hmm. So when I got to New York, I went in this room and I said, I would like to sing 4 songs. If I can't sing all 4, I don't wish to sing any. I'd never do that now.
They must have bought that right on the spot.
Well, this man was in bed, and he had a piano over the bed hanging.
Yeah.
And he said, carry on all 4s, you know. And it was Cole Porter. And he had this terrible accident.
The horse accident.
Yeah, and then he was in his living room, but the piano was above his bed, suspended.
I never knew that.
You see, I thought show business was very funny.
People stayed in bed and played
the piano. And, you know, and there was a lot of people around the room.
Mm-hmm.
They happened to be Sophie Tucker. And
would that have been in... He lived in the Waldorf, didn't he?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the thing is that they were stuck, in a way.
Yeah.
So... he said, carry on all 4, so I did. That meant I sang 4 songs.
But here is the Cole Porter song that brought Mary to fame called My Heart Belongs to Daddy. In a scene, just a few seconds of it here from Night and Day, which came out a few years ago.
So did I.
While tearing off a game of golf, I may make a play for the caddy. But when I do, I don't follow through, 'cause my heart belongs to Daddy. If I invite a boy some night to dine on my fine linen hattie, I just adore his asking for more, but my heart belongs to Daddy. Yes, my heart belongs to Daddy, so I simply couldn't ask. Yes, my heart belongs to Daddy. Daddy, so I want to warn you, laddie, though I think you're perfectly swell, that my heart belongs to Daddy, and my daddy, he treats it so well.
Ah.
just realized that...
Wonderful, Mary.
Realized where I'd seen that. It was on Phil Donahue's...
We've been thinking of that all through that summer.
Well, I got that in, didn't I?
Phil did another salute, huh?
Can I ask you a technical question?
Moi?
Yeah. When they shoot a song like that, we know that, you know, they have to shoot a master shot and then a close-up and so on, but how do they cut it together when you had to sing it three times for each?
This never bothered me. That was their problem.
Yeah. You didn't mess with that. Good answer.
I never knew where I was anyway, before. I made 12 pictures, and they'd give me a place to stay, and I'd stay. And other people would be backing up, and I'd stay. But
Mary, it was then, but from that one night, it was instant stardom on Broadway.
Instant stardom on Broadway, but it was a lot of years in front. Teaching dancing. I taught that for 3 years, and from having three pupils, I had 300 in three schools of dancing at 19. They didn't know much more than I did, so I went to school at night, studied.
Surely somewhere along the way, somebody said, "You'll never make it because of that awful Texas accent."
Billy Rose.
Yeah.
Said, "Go home to your diapers," and he said, "You have something. I don't quite know what it is. You're too good for the chorus. You're not good enough for a part." So he said, "Go home to your diapers," and that meant my baby. Mm-hmm. And that my baby turned out to be the meanest thing on television.
But not to his mama.
Never.
No. How many grandchildren do you have?
Six.
Six grandchildren.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
And Heidi's married, Larry's first child.
Right.
And I keep saying, it's not too many years I'm going to be around. Do you know what I was made on my last birthday?
No.
I was made a Boy Scout. And no one's ever been made a Boy Scout.
No, but it's only right.
And
I think they do it in Sweden, don't they?
No, they do it the other way around. But anyways, this was after the accident, and Jimmy Stewart had been on the show. Oh, pardon me, Over Easy.
Yeah.
And I'm so scared after seeing that number. I keep putting my... and he wrote a letter, and he said, we'd like to make you a Boy Scout. And I thought, well, I really never wanted to be a Girl Scout. But I sure would like to be a Boy Scout.
Yeah, that's true.
So on my 70th...
Be prepared.
70th birthday, I was made a Boy Scout.
Isn't that great, Mary?
Isn't there something?
Hey, Merv, what are you going to...
I just want to show him the book cover again, because I don't want him to miss it. Mary Martin, My Heart Belongs.
I got an idea, a musical you and I could write for Mary.
What?
A huge Broadway star who, without any experience, goes into the chorus and makes it as a chorus girl.
Someday in my
will you write it? Will you promise?
We'll come back after the road. Mary Martin. Thanks to Dick Cavett and to Mary Martin. It's extraordinary to have you both here. And that's it for today.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, we're finished?
We are done.
Bye,
and tomorrow is the 4th of July. Have a great one. But be sure you come back to us. Well, thank you, Mary. Thank you, Dick. Bye-bye. Promotional consideration paid for by the college.